Hey everyone, welcome to Coding Simplified, and today we'll solve a new problem in binary tree. So basically we need to check that given a two binary tree, whether they are mirror to each other or not, right? So mirror to each other or not means, as you can see from here itself, like in this tree, if you see that where here we have 2, 7, 5 in the left side and 8 in the right side. So if you place a mirror here, exactly it will reflect this one. So this 8 will come here at left and 7 and 5 will appear to the right, right? So like in this case, both are mirrored to each other. So that's what we need to find out, that whether the both trees are mirrored to each other or not, right? So now first of all, let's see the logic that how we can check this. So now let's say I have two binary tree and both binary trees are empty at the starting, right? So let's say this is first binary tree which is null, and this is another binary tree which is also null, means there is no such binary tree. So in this case we can say both are mirror. Yes, though they are null, but they are mirror, right? So we'll check that if both the elements are null, it means they are mirror tree. But let's say if any one of is null and other is not null. So like let's say this one is null, but this is not null. This has, let's say, one node, let's say 7, right? Or let's say this can have let's say we have one node here, but this is null. So in this case we can say that this is not mirror, right? Because here we have null and here we have 7, here we have 7, here we have null. So in both the cases it will not be a mirror tree, right? So basically these are our base condition. Now check some other cases. So let's say if I have another tree here, so in this case I have only one, and here also I have one node, but the data is different, right? So in this case also I can see that yes, there are only one node, but data is different, so it is also not a mirror tree, right? Now let's say if we take one case, so in both the cases I have one node. So in this case I can say yes, both are mirror tree, because there is only one node in both the trees, and both and data is also equal. So in this is mirror tree. But let's say I have one more tree, so I can see that the one node is okay, but let's say if they have more nodes. So like here we have 2 and here we have, let's say, 2. So are they mirror tree? Yes. No, they are not mirror tree, right? Because they both are in the same side. But if this 2 was at this one, so let's say if this 2 was at this one, at right side, now are they mirror tree? Yes, now they are mirror tree, because if I take a mirror, so this 2 will appear this side, right? So as you can see that what we will do, we'll start from the root node, we'll check the content, that whether the contents are matching or not. And after matching the content recursively, we'll move to the left and right, right? So once we have checked out that yes, their root node is matching, so we can say that whether if node 1 of data, node 2 of data. So if they are matching, if both node 1 and node 2 are matching, then further I need to check, let's say my name is recursively, I'm checking mirror. So node 1 of left and node 2 of right. Right, because as you can see that, because I know they are mirrored, so basically I need to check with the left and with the right, right? So that is why I'm saying that send the data mirror node 1 dot left and node 2 of right, and similarly check for the node 1 of right and node 2 of left. Right, so that will solve our problem, because once we have checked out the root node, a particular node, then we need to iterate the further nodes. So in this case I will check with this one, I will send the node 1 of left and node 2 of right, and let's say if there was another node, let's say 3, and let's say here it was 5. So once we have checked with this one, then we'll send the node 1 of right and then node 2 of left, and then it will again check. So like in this case, when it will check this one, the data is not matching, so it will return false. But if it was equal, then it would return true, right? So this is how we'll solve this problem. Now what will be the time complexity? So as you can see that what I'm doing at a one time, I'm solving this particular node, and recursively I'm solving the other nodes. So basically I need to iterate on all the nodes. So it means my time complexity will be big of n, because if we have n element in n, so ideally you can say that if it has, because both the elements has n element, or let's say if it has any different element, n element or m element, so we can say that n plus m, but in all we can say overall it will be big of n, which is linear, right? Now what will be the space complexity? So if we talk about the space complexity, because as such we are not taking any extra space, so space complexity will be big of 1, right? Now let me show you through a simple code as well what I'm doing. So here I have created the two trees. This is the first tree and this is second tree, and here I'm passing the call in if mirror tree, where I'm passing the root 1 and root 2, right? So if you go here, this is a basic condition that if node 1 equal to and node, and if both node 1 and node 2 is null, then return true, right? And if any one of is null, then return false, right? So these are the two basic condition that I was talking about. Else it's a basic condition that first of all check the both data, if both data is matching, and go with the left and right, and then right and left, right? So this is a basic code to check that if both the trees are mirror tree or not, right? And guys, I will also put the source code into description, so you can copy from there and you can check at your end as well, right? So thanks guys for watching it, and if you have any doubt regarding this, please write in the comment section. And guys, if you have liked the video, then please like it and subscribe the channel for more such videos. Thank you.